Is it true that a vegan diet can lead to hair loss, or is this another example of meat eaters hating on vegans? If you're looking for a fair, researched answer, you've come to the right place. Stay tuned. Welcome to the Hair Guard YouTube channel, where we create science-backed videos all about how you can combat hair loss and regrow healthy hair. If you want updating on any of the latest breakthroughs that we find out about, make sure to hit subscribe and turn on notifications. And guys, if you're watching this video because you're personally worried about your hair loss, then what you can do is click the link in the description to take the Hair Guard Hair Loss Quiz. You'll answer a few short questions about yourself and your hair loss, then you'll receive free expert advice on regrowing healthy hair. So now let's get into the video on veganism and hair loss. Well, a vegan is somebody who doesn't eat animal or animal products, including things like eggs and dairy. So it's basically a stricter version of vegetarianism, as most vegetarians include dairy in their diet. Now, just because you're a vegan does not automatically mean that you're eating healthy. You can still fully fit the vegan definition and live on such junk food as potato chips, cookies, and crackers. But that's not what we will be talking about today. Instead, we'll be focusing on the healthy vegan diet that consists of things like whole grains, nuts, seeds, fruits, vegetables, and so on. So, now that we have the definition out of the way, let's ask the question once again. Can a vegan diet lead to hair loss? Well, it actually depends on the specifics of the diet. The key here is iron, particularly when it comes to female vegans. You see, iron deficiency is the leading cause of diffuse hair loss amongst women, with some studies suggesting that it could be linked to as many as 2/3 of cases. The exact mechanism by which iron deficiency causes hair loss is actually not known for sure. One possible way is by serving as a trigger for the expression of certain genes that are involved in hair growth. Another possibility is that iron deficiency impedes the production of ribonucleotide reductase, which is a key enzyme in DNA production. And since certain hair follicle cells are among the most rapidly dividing in the body, anything that slows down the production of genetic material will cause serious problems. Now, the causes of iron deficiency fall into three general categories. Firstly, there's decreased iron absorption. Now, this can be due to stomach and intestinal conditions, abuse of antacid medications, or simply unfortunate genetics. Secondly, periods of increased iron needs, such as pregnancy, heavy periods, or parasite infection. And thirdly, dietary iron deficiency, brought about by crash dieting or an unbalanced vegan diet. Consider that some of the most common iron-rich foods will be lacking in a vegan diet, because these do include eggs, red meat, chicken, turkey, liver, and seafood. Now, if you're a vegan watching this video, there is some good and bad news. The good news, as you probably already know, is that you can get iron from a variety of non-animal food products, like lentils, beans, spinach, and many more plant foods. Now, we'll come back to that later. The bad news is that there is a difference between the iron that you get in animal products versus plant products. The iron in animal products is of a kind called heme iron, whereas the iron in plant-based food is non-heme. Crucially, heme iron is more readily absorbed in the circulation and therefore makes a larger contribution to dietary iron for most people. But vegans, on the other hand, will have to rely exclusively on non-heme iron, which is not as easily absorbed. For this reason, they have been estimated to require as much as 1.8 times the amount of iron compared to meat eaters. So, you basically have a double whammy of the vegan diet, which is that it typically leads to the consumption of lower levels of iron, while requiring higher levels in the first place due to the kind of iron the diet involves. Aside from hair loss, other symptoms of iron deficiency include low energy and fatigue, and the feeling of being constantly tired. Now, if you are on a vegan diet and are concerned about your hair or are experiencing hair loss, the way to get a test for dietary iron deficiency is with a ferritin test. We have covered ferritin in a previous video, which I've linked to in the description below. Briefly, it's the protein that your body uses to store iron, and low levels of this protein can reveal an iron deficiency and even anemia. The good news is that hair loss due to an iron-deficient vegan diet is easily reversible. As soon as the underlying iron deficiency is addressed, the hair will start to grow back. Now, if you don't want to go back to eating red meat, the two other best ways to boost your iron levels are A, supplementation in the form of tablets that you can find in any health food store, or B, eating larger quantities of iron-rich plant foods. Now, you can eat some of the foods that we previously mentioned earlier, like lentils, beans, and spinach, and other iron-rich vegan foods include tofu, soybeans, chickpeas, and seeds like pumpkin and sesame seeds. And whatever you do, you want to be consuming an adequate amount of calories. Running a high caloric deficit on an iron-starved diet is one of the worst things that you can do for your hair. If you have ever experienced hair loss on a vegan diet, we'd love to hear from you in the comments below. How soon after going vegan did you notice that your hair started to fall off? And what steps did you take to reverse it? And if you want to learn any more about nutrition and hair loss, click the videos on the screen now.